Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. American Musical Theater of San Jose would like to remind you that the taking of photographs and the use of recording devices is strictly prohibited by union regulations and copyright laws. And in consideration of fellow patrons, we ask that you please silence all pagers and cellular phones during tonight's performance. And now American Musical Theater's executive producer, Mr. Stuart Slater.
Thank you. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of all of us at AMT, it's a great pleasure to welcome each of you to the theater this evening and to this special 50th year anniversary production of South Pacific. We've been waiting all season long to share this production with you, so we're very glad that each and every one of you is here in the theater tonight. As much time, however, as we've been spending on this production, we've also saved, well, quite a bit of time in working on our plans for next season, as well as our plans for this summer. As many of you already know, we're going to be up at the Mountain Winery in Saratoga this summer presenting a chorus line. We're very pleased and proud to be a part of that series, and we would invite you to join us the last week in July for a chorus line. Next season, we again will be presenting four great shows here at the CPA, and I would invite you to join us for each and every one of those performances. Now, I know many of you are current season ticket holders, and you've already renewed your tickets, but for the one or two of you who have not yet done so, or for those individual ticket buyers who would like to join our growing season ticket family, I would invite you to refer to the materials in your theater program, in the theater lobbies, and to drop by the box office during the intermission tonight and renew your tickets or purchase your tickets for the very first time. Once again, we're very glad that each one of you is here, and now it is with a great deal of pleasure. The American Musical Theater of San Jose very proudly presents South Pacific.
yesterday, December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy. The United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan. The attack yesterday on the Hawaiian Islands has caused severe damage to American naval and military forces. I regret to tell you that very many American lives have been lost. With confidence in our armed forces, with the unbounding determination of our people, we will gain the inevitable triumph, so help us God.
Is frangipani.
What a color!
You will find many more flowers out here. Je serai le café.
Oui, monsieur.
C'est tout.
Oui, monsieur de Beck.
Well, I'm just speechless. When that lunch, wild chicken? Hmm? I didn't know it was ever wild. Gosh, well, I had no idea that people live like this. I mean, right out in the middle of the Pacific Ocean.
Sugar.
Oh, thanks.
One.
Three. I know it's a big load for a demi-tasse to carry. All right, I'm a hick. You know so many American words. Do you know what a hick is?
Oui. A hick is one who lives in a stick.
Sticks. Plural. The stick.
Pardon, the sticks. Plural, I remember.
How long did it take you to build up a plantation like this?
I came to the Pacific when I was a very young man.
Emile, is it true that all the planters on these islands, are they all running away from something?
Ah, who is not running away from something? There are fugitives everywhere, New York, Paris, even Small Rock, where you come from.
Little Rock.
Ah, Little Rock. you know fugitives there?
I will show you a picture of a Little Rock fugitive.
Hmm.
I got this clipping from my mother today.
Ah, Ensign Nellie Forbush, Arkansas's own Florence Nightingale.
That was written by Mrs. Leeming, the social editor. She went to school with my mother. To read her, you would think that I'm practically the most important nurse in the entire Navy, and that it's only a matter of time before I become a Lady Admiral.
In this picture, you do not look much like an admiral.
Well, that was taken before I knew what rain and heat and mud could do to your disposition. Oh, but it isn't rainy today. Oh, gosh, it's so beautiful here. Now, look at that yellow sun. You know, I don't think it's the end of the world like everyone else thinks. I just can't work myself up to getting that low. You think I'm crazy, too. They all do, over at the Fleet Hospital. You know what they call me? Knucklehead Nellie. I suppose I am, but I can't help it. When the sky is a bright canary yellow, I forget every cloud I've ever seen. So they call me a cockeyed optimist, immature and incurably green. I have heard people rant and rave and bellow that we're done and we might as well be dead. But I'm only a cockeyed optimist, and I can't get it into my head. I hear the human race is falling on its face and hasn't very far to go. But every whippoorwill is selling me a bill and telling me it just ain't so. I could say life is just a bowl of jello and appear and smart, but I'm stuck like a dope with a thing called hope, and I can't get it out of my heart. Not this heart. You want to know anything else about me?
Yes. You say you are a fugitive. When you joined the Navy, what were you running away from?
Gosh, I don't know. It was more like I was running to something. I wanted to see what the world was like outside Little Rock, I mean. And I wanted to meet different kinds of people, find out if I like them better. And I'm finding out.
Would you like some cognac?
I'd love some. Wonder how I feel living on a hillside, looking on an ocean beautiful and still.
This is what I need. This is what I've longed for. Someone young and smiling, climbing up my hill.
We are not alike. Probably I bore him. He's a cultured Frenchman. I'm a little hick.
Younger men than I, officers and doctors, probably pursue her. She could have her pick.
Wonder why I feel jittery and jumpy. I am like a schoolgirl waiting for a dance.
Can I ask her now? I am like a schoolboy. What will be her answer? Do I have a chance?
Thank you.
In peacetime, the boat from America comes once a month. The ladies, the wives of the planters, often go to Australia during the hot months. It can get very hot here.
We can get hot in Arkansas, too.
Ah, yes?
Yes.
I have many books here. Marcel Proust, André Gide. Did you study French in school?
Oh, yes.
Ah, then you can read French.
Oh, no. I can conjugate a few verbs. I bet you read a lot.
Oh, out here, one becomes hungry to learn everything, not to miss anything, not to let anything good pass by. One waits so long for what is good, when at last it comes, one cannot risk to lose, even if it... One must act quickly. Seems foolish to be so quick. I know it is only 2 weeks. A dinner given at your officer's club, do you remember?
Oh, yes, I remember.
But that is how it happens sometimes. Isn't it, Nellie?
Yes, it is, Emile.
Some enchanted evening, you may see a stranger. I see a stranger across a crowded room, and somehow you know even then, that somewhere you'll see her again and again. Some If we have children, when I die, they will be growing up. You could afford to take them back to America, if you like. Will you think about it?
Monsieur de Beck, la jupe de mademoiselle est ici. La jupe de mademoiselle. Votre jeep.
My jeep. Oh, my jeep! Oh, thank you, Henry. Oh, gosh, I'm on duty in 10 minutes.
Nellie, before you go, I want to tell you something. A moment ago, you asked me a question. Why did I leave France?
Oh, Emile, that was really none of my business.
But I want to tell you. I had to leave France. I killed a man.
Why did you kill him?
He was a wicked man, a bully. Everyone in our village was glad to see him die. It was not to my discredit. Do you believe me, Nellie?
You have just told me that you killed a man and that it is all right. I hardly know you, and yet I know it is all right.
Oh, thank you, Nellie. Nellie, do you like my place?
Oh, yes.
You will think.
I will think.
Lipstick. Three lumps of sugar in this little cup. Mm-hmm. Eh bien!
Bravo, papa! Ah,
merci.
Nous chantons bien aussi.
Ah, oui!
Attends, papa. Attends, papa.
Dites-moi, pourquoi la vie est belle?
Dites-moi,
pourquoi la vie est belle?
Parce que
mais
oh, très bien.
Bloody Mary is a girl I love. Bloody Mary is a girl I love. Bloody Mary is a girl I love. Now ain't that too damn bad? Her skin is tender as Dimaggio's love. Her skin is tender as Dimaggio's love.
Stingy bastard!
Stingy bastard! That good?
Oh, that's great, Mary. You're learning fast.
Stingy bastard! I learn fast. Pretty soon, I talk English good as any karami money. Stingy bastard!
She is always chewing beetle nuts. Bloody Mary's chewing beetle nuts, and she don't use Pepsodent. Now ain't that too damn bad?
Hey, what is that thing?
His head. $50.
What's it made of?
Made out of head. It's real human.
What makes it so small?
Schlunk. Only way to keep human head is schlanker.
No thanks.
$4. Send home Chicago to Saxy sweetheart. She make waves like this.
Thank you. sweaty pie. Put them down, Professor. Now these beautiful skirts were made by myself, the professor here, and three other Seabees in half the time it takes your native workers to make them. See? No stretch. So look them over, sweaty pie, and give me your price, huh?
Come on, Professor.
Hey, take a look at this shirt.
Take it up with our manager.
Hey, big dealer. Hey, Luther Billis. Yeah, what can I do for you, my boy? What's the trouble? Well, take a look at this shirt. The Billis Laundry is not responsible for minor burns and tears, huh? So what do you say, sweat so? What am I offered?
All hands so?
Gee, mighty nice work.
You hear that, sweaty pie? You can probably sell these to the chumps for $5 or $6 apiece. I'll tell you what. I'll give you the whole bunch for, say, $80.
Give you $10.
What?
Not enough?
You damn well right, not enough.
Then you damn well keep.
Now look here, dragon lady. Hey. What's that you got there? Is that a boar's tooth bracelet? Where'd you get it at? Over there on Valley High, huh?
You lie?
Hey, you know what this is? It's a bracelet made from a single boar's tooth. Yeah, they cut the tooth from the boar's mouth in a big ceremonial over there on Valley High. They're in a souvenir you can pick up in the South Pacific as valuable as this. Mary, what do you want for it?
$100.
What? That's cheap. I thought it would be more.
I don't see how she can turn them out for that.
Yeah.
Make you special offer, big dealer. I trade you boar's tooth bracelet for all gaskets.
It's a deal.
Wait a minute. What? It's no deal till you throw in something for good luck.
Okay. What do you want me to throw in?
$100. Good luck.
You don't run into these things every day. These are as scarce as hen's teeth.
They're bigger, too.
That damn Valley High. Why does it have to be off limits? You can get everything over there. Bracelets, shrunken heads, old ivory.
Young French women.
Knock it off. I'm talking about souvenirs.
So is he.
We gotta get a boat and get out of here. I'm starting to feel held down again. I need to take a trip.
Only officers can sign out boats.
Oh, yeah? Well, I'll get a boat, all right. I'm gonna latch onto some officer who's got some imagination that would like to see the boar's tooth ceremonial as much as I would. It's a hell of a ceremonial. Dancing, drinking, everything.
You big phony. We all know why you want to go to Valley High.
Why?
Because French planters put all their young women out there when they heard that us GIs were coming. That's why. It ain't boar's teeth. It's women.
It's boar's teeth! And women!
We got sunlight on the sand, we got moonlight on the sea.
We got mangoes and bananas you can pick right off the tree.
We got volleyball and ping pong and a lot of dandy games.
What ain't we got?
We ain't got games!
We get packages from home. We get shows.
We get speeches from our skipper and advice from Tokyo Rose.
We get lettuce doused with playfield and get dizzy from the smell.
What don't we get?
You know damn well.
We got nothing to put on a clean white suit for. What we need is what there ain't no substitute for.
There is nothing like a day.
Every kind of feeling,
but the feeling of relief.
We feel hungry as the wolf of winning men, Red Riding Hood.
What don't we feel?
We don't feel good.
Lots of things in life are beautiful, but brother, there is one particular thing that is nothing whatsoever in any way, shape, or form like any other.
There is nothing like a day.
Has a
frame.
Have you done what you promised?
Yes, Miss Forbush. I did it last night. Hey, hey, you don't have to open it here.
Oh, Loesser, you do beautiful work. You've even done the pleats in my shorts.
Well, pleats ain't hard. You better run along now. Your gang is waiting for you.
Pleats are very hard. How do you do such delicate work at night, in the dark?
Well, there was a moon.
There was a moon?
A full moon!
How much, Loesser?
Oh, no, no. Not from you.
Gosh, I guess I'm just about the luckiest nurse on this island to have found you. You're a treasure. Well, goodbye, Loesser. Up, two, three, four!
Nice little girl, that one. But most of them nurses,
the officers can have them.
They got them.
Well, they can have them.
So, suppose a day made bright or completely free from flaws.
Or as faithful as a bird dog.
Or as kind as Santa Claus.
It's a waste of time to worry over things that we have not.
Be thankful for
the things they've got.
Even crummier than that. I'm a lieutenant.
Lieutenant?
Lieutenant.
Hiya, Lieutenant. New on the rock?
Just came in on that PBY.
Yeah, where from?
A little island south of Marie Louise.
So you got from up where they use real bullets?
Uh-huh.
Hey, Lieutenant. You damn sexy man.
Well, thanks. You're looking pretty fit yourself.
Damn sexy.
Who is she?
She Tonkanese, yeah. Used to work for some French planter.
French planter, stingy bastard!
Hey, I wonder if any of you fellas know a French planter named Debec?
Emile Debec? Yeah, I think he's that guy that lives on top of that hill. Why, you know him?
No, but I'm going to.
Hey, Lieutenant. Real human head. You got sweetheart? Send home Chicago to sexy sweetheart.
No, she's a Philadelphia girl.
What's that? Philadelphia. What's that mean? No sexy? You like I give you free?
Free? You never give me anything free.
You not sexy like Lutella. Take.
No, thank you. Where'd you get that, anyway?
Bali High.
officer. There's your officer.
Yeah, that's that island over there with the two volcanoes. Officers can get launches and go over there.
Bali High. What does that mean?
Bali High mean I am your special island. Mean here I am. Bali High is your special island, Lutella. I know. You listen. You hear island call to you? Listen. You hear something? Listen.
I hear the sound of the wind and the waves. That's all.
You know, hear something call to you. Listen.
I think I hear something.
Shut your big fat mouth.
Hear a voice?
Most people live on a lonely island, lost in the middle of a foggy sea.
Lieutenant, right now that island is off limits due to the fact that the French planters have all their young women running around over there. Of course, you being an officer, you could get a launch. I'd even be willing to requisition a boat for you. So what do you say, Lieutenant? Bally High may call you any night, any day. In your heart, you hear it call you. Come away, come away. Huh, Lieutenant?
No.
Yeah, yeah, I see what you mean. You know, being off limits and all. Take a lot of persuading to get me to go over there. But another thing goes on over there. The ceremonial of the boar's tooth. Yeah, yeah, after they kill the boar, they pass around this coconut liquor, and all the girls dance with just skirts on. And everybody gets to know everybody pretty well. Bally High will whisper on the wind of the sea. Here am I, your special island. Come to me, come to me. Yeah, it's just a little tribal ceremonial. Primitive, but astonishing. And I figured, you know, since you've been up in the shooting war for such a long time without getting any recreation, well, you know, I thought you might be interested.
I am. But right now, I've got to report to the island commander.
Ah, Professor! Take the lieutenant up in the truck.
Professor?
Yeah, that's because he went to college. You go to college?
Yes.
Yeah, where?
A little place in New Jersey.
Yeah, where? Rutgers?
No, Princeton.
Your folks got money, huh? Don't be ashamed of it. We understand. Say, how'd you like to hear the professor talk some language? Yeah, yeah, what do you want to hear? Latin? Grecian? Give him some Latin.
Rectius, vives, Lachidi.
Ain't that beautiful?
Nequa altum semper agendodum procellus.
Yeah! Now, Lieutenant, what did he say?
I'm afraid I haven't the slightest idea.
What's the matter? Didn't you graduate? Take the lieutenant to the buildings.
Aye, aye.
He'll never make captain.
Look, look, look! Iron Belly!
Here she is, sir.
You are causing an economic revolution on this island. These French planters can't find a native to pick a coconut or milk a cow because you're paying them 10 times as much to make these ridiculous grass skirts.
French planters!
Sir, may I make a suggestion, sir?
Who are you?
Billis, sir. Luther Billis? Yeah. The natives can now go back to work on the farms. The demand for grass skirts can now be met by us, Seabees.
Dressmakers? Yeah. Do you mean to tell me that the Seabees of the United States Navy are now a lot of...
I don't like the idea, sir. We can drop it right here, sir. Just say the word. Just pretend I never brought it up.
Luther Billis?
Yes, sir.
Oh. Nothing. Just making a mental note. I want to be sure not to forget your name.
I want to see you pick up every scrap of this paraphernalia now, and for the last time, carry it way down there beyond that fence, off Navy property!
Well, come on, everybody! Take all this stuff and throw it over that fence. Let's go!
Yeah! Come on, everybody! Off Navy property! Let's go!
You go, too.
All right, Lieutenant. Thank you.
Lieutenant.
I'm Lieutenant Joseph Cable, sir. I just flew in on that PBY.
A joyride?
No, sir. Orders.
A Marine under orders to me?
Yes, sir.
I'm Captain Brackett.
How do you do, sir?
This is Commander Harbison, my executive officer.
How do you do?
Pleased to meet you.
Well, what's it all about?
Well, sir, my colonel feels that all these islands are in danger because none of us has been getting first-hand intelligence, and that what we need is a coast watch.
A coast watch?
A man with a radio, hiding out on one of these Japanese-held islands, watching for enemy ships when they start down the bottleneck.
What do you think, Bill?
Well, sir, our pilots could do a hell of a lot to their convoys with information like that.
You'd have to sneak the man ashore at night from a submarine.
Yes, sir.
Who's gonna go?
Well, sir, I've been elected.
You've got quite an assignment, son.
How long do you think you could last there, sending out messages before the bad guys found you?
I think I'd be okay if I could take a man with me who knew the territory. Headquarters has found out there's a French civilian here who used to have a plantation over on Marie-Louise Island.
Marie-Louise. That's a good spot, right on the bottleneck.
What's this Frenchman's name?
Emile Debec.
Meet me in my office in about half an hour, Cable.
Yes, sir.
Come on, Bill. Maybe we'll get into this war yet.
Expression, Lieutenant, just act like we're talking casual. I got in the boat.
What boat?
Keep your voice down. I signed out a boat in your name. We're shoving off for Bally High in 45 minutes.
No, we're not. I've got to see Captain Brackett.
Lieutenant, what are you trying to do to me? I signed out that boat in your name.
Well, then you're just the guy to go back and cancel it. Now forget the whole thing.
Lieutenant, you and me are going on that boat, whether you like it or not.
Ah, Cable, we've got some dope on your Frenchman. Marie-Louise Island came down here about 16 years ago, lived with a Polynesian woman for about 5 years, 2 children by her. She died. Here's something we've got to clear up. Seems he left France in a big hurry. Killed a guy. What do you think of that?
Might be a handy man to have around.
Cable, come here.
Oh, good. Send her in. No, we don't have time for her to change into her uniform. Tell her to come in. Come in, Miss Forbush.
Captain Brackett, please excuse the way I
look. You look just fine. May I present Commander Harbison?
Oh, I have the pleasure of seeing Miss Forbush twice a week. Yeah, we serve together on the GI Entertainment Committee.
Oh. May I also present Lieutenant Joseph Cable, Miss Forbush?
Hello.
How do you do?
Have a seat, Miss Forbush. So, how's the Thanksgiving entertainment coming?
Oh, very well, thank you, sir. We practice whenever we get a chance.
About a week ago, you had lunch with a French planter, Emile Debec.
Yes, sir.
What do you know about him?
What do I know about him?
That's right.
Well, we met at the officers' club dance. He was there, and I met him. Then I had lunch with him.
Yes, now, what kind of a man is he?
Oh, he's very nice. He's kind. He's attractive. I just don't know what you want to know, sir.
Miss Forbush, Captain Brackett wants to know, did you discuss politics?
No, sir.
Would you have discussed politics, Commander? What we are specifically interested in is, when these fellows come out from France, it's generally because they've had some trouble. Now, has he ever told you anything about that? What do you know about his family?
He has no family, no wife, nobody.
No, he hasn't any children.
No, sir.
And you say he never told you why he left France?
Yes, he left France because he killed a man.
Did he tell you why?
No, but he will if I ask him.
Well, Miss Forbush, that's exactly what we'd like to have you do. Find out all you can about him. His background, his opinions, and why he killed this man in France.
In other words, you want me to spy on him?
I'm afraid it is something like that.
Why? Do you suspect him of something?
No. It's just that we don't know very much about him, and he... Will you help us, Miss Forbush?
I'll try.
Thank you. You may go now if you wish.
I don't know very much about him, really. Do I?
He's kept a few secrets from her, hasn't he?
Well, you don't spring a couple of Polynesian kids on a woman right off the bat.
Well, I don't think we're gonna get much out of her. It's obvious she's in love with him.
I find that hard to believe, sir. They tell me he's a middle-aged man.
Cable! It is a common mistake for boys of your age and athletic ability to underestimate men who have reached their maturity.
Oh, I didn't mean, sir, that you...
Young women frequently find grown men attractive, strange as that may seem to you. I myself am over 50. I'm a bachelor, and Cable, I do not by any means consider myself through. What's the matter, Bill?
Nothing, evidently.
Okay, Cable, see you at Chow. You play any bridge?
Yes, sir.
Got any money?
Yes, sir.
I'll take it away from you.
Yes, sir.
What makes you so damn sure this mission won't work out?
Marie Louise Island is 24 miles long by 3 miles wide. Let's say that every time they send out a transmission, they move to another hill. Seems to me, looking at this thing...
Realistically?
Realistically? It'd last about a week.
Of course, it would be worth it if it were the right week. With some decent information, our side might finally get moving. Operation Alligator might get off its can.
Here it is, sir. I got it.
Okay, Bill. See you at Chow. See you at Chow, Bill?
Oh, yeah. See you at Chow.
Got the address right?
I think so. Mrs. Amelia Fortuna, 325 Euclid Avenue, Shaker Heights, Cleveland, Ohio.
That's right. I want to pack it myself.
Yes, sir.
Bali High.
Letter from home?
Yes. Do you get letters from your mother telling you that everything you do is wrong?
No. My mother thinks everything I do is right. Of course, I don't tell her everything I do.
My mother is so prejudiced.
Against Frenchmen.
Against anyone outside Little Rock. She makes a big thing out of two people having different backgrounds.
Ages?
Oh, no. Mother thinks that older men are better for girls than younger men.
This has been a very discouraging day for me.
Do you agree with Mother about people having things in common? For instance, if the man likes symphony music and the girl likes Dinah Shore, and the man reads Marcel Proust and the girl doesn't read anything, what do you think? Do you think Mother's right?
Well, she might be.
Well, I don't think she is.
Well, maybe she's not.
Well, goodbye, Lieutenant. You've helped a lot.
Listen. You don't know so much about that guy. You'd better look that letter over two or three times.
I'll show you what I think of that idea.
Well, don't say I didn't warn you.
Sorry, I thought Miss Forbush was here. I brought her some hot water. She likes to take a shampoo on Fridays, all right?
Hey, Luther.
Oh, hi, Miss Forbush. I brought you some hot water.
Oh.
Thanks. It'll do me some good to get the sand out of my hair.
If you need some extra water for rinsing out your hair, my bath club concession boys will take care of you.
Yeah, we'll wash anything.
Shut up. Now, when you're ready for your shower, all you gotta do is pull down on this little chain here. Just like you was, well, like you was pulling down on a window shade, okay?
Right.
Oh. Sorry. Sorry. We'll see you. Oh, bye. Ow.
So, what did he say? Huh? What did he say?
Who?
Iron Belly!
Oh, Captain Brackett? Nothing. Nothing important. Just... something about the Thanksgiving show.
Well, what's the trouble, Knucklehead?
Huh?
I said, what's the trouble?
Nothing.
There's not going to be any trouble anymore because I have made up my mind about one thing. It's all off.
With him?
Mm-hmm. I'm going to break it off clean before it's too late.
Knucklehead, what's happened?
What did he do?
Well, he didn't do anything. It's just that I don't know very much about him, really. And before I go any further with this thing, I just better not get started. Don't you think so too, Dinah?
Well, yes, I do.
You do? Well, I guess I do too. Oh, and now don't look so dramatic about it. Things like this happen every day. I'm gonna wash that man right out of my hair. I'm gonna wash that man right out of my hair. I'm gonna wash that man right out of my hair and send him on his way. Get the picture. I'm gonna wave that man right out of my arms. I'm gonna wave that man right out of my arms. I'm gonna wave that man right out of my arms and send him on his way. Don't try to patch it up.
Tear it up, tear it up.
Wash him out, dry him out.
Push him out, fly him out.
Cancel him and let him go.
Yeah, sister.
I'm gonna wash that man right out of my hair. I'm gonna wash that man right out of my hair. I'm gonna wash that man right out of my hair and send him on his way. If the man don't understand you, if you fly on separate beams, change. Ride that man right off your reins. Rub him out of the roll call and drum him out of your dreams.
Oh,
if you laugh at different comics, if you root for different teams,
waste no time, weep no more. Show him what the dare is for. Rub him out of the roll call and drum him.
You never think
this was an evening dress, would you? We're only allowed to bring two evening dresses. Only two I brought.
Hello. I left a message for you at the hospital. It was to invite you to my home for dinner next Friday.
Oh, Emile, I don't think I'll be able to come.
But I have invited all of my friends, the planters' colony.
Oh, a big party. Well, then if I can't come, you won't miss me.
But it is for you, for my friends to meet you, and more importantly, for you to meet them, to find out what your life would be like here on the island, and to learn more about me, how I live and how I think.
Know more about you?
Yes, you know very little about me.
Well, that's right. Would you sit down a minute? Do you think about politics much? And if so, what do you think about politics?
Do you mean my political philosophy?
I think that's what I mean.
Well, to begin with, I believe in the free life. Freedom for everyone.
Like in the Declaration of Independence?
C'est ça. All men are created equal, isn't it?
Emile, do you really believe that?
Yes.
Well, thank goodness.
It is why I am here. Why I killed a man.
Oh, yes. I meant to ask you about that, too. I don't want you to think that I'm prying into your personal life, asking a lot of questions, but I always think it's interesting why a person kills another person.
Of course. That has worried you, Nellie. When I was a little boy, I carried my heart in my hand. So, when this man came to town, though my father said he was good, I thought he was bad. I was young. He attracted all of the cruel and wicked men to him, and pretty soon he was running our town. He could go anywhere, take anything, do anything. I did not like this. I was young. I stood in the middle of the town and made a speech. I asked everyone to join me against this man.
What did they do?
They walked away.
Why?
Because they could see him standing behind me. I turned to him, and he said to me, "I am going to kill you now." We fought. I was never so strong. I threw him to the ground and he hit his head on a stone. And I ran to the dockyard and joined a cargo boat. I did not even know where it was going. And I got off of that boat into a different world, where I am now and where I want to stay. Nellie, will you marry me? We have so few days in our life. This time I have with you now is precious to me. Have you been thinking?
I have been thinking. Born on the opposite sides of a sea, we are as different as people can be.
It's true. Somewhere you'll see her again.
enchanted evening. When you find your true love, when you feel her call you across a crowded room, then fly to her side and make her your own. All through your life you may dream all alone.
Once you have found him, never let him go.
Once you have found her, never.
Come next Friday.
Yes.
Well, she sure washed him out of her hair.
Oh, quiet, she'll hear you.
I expect every one of my crowd to make fun of my proud protestations of faith and romance. And they'll say I'm naive as a babe to believe any fable I hear from a person in pants. Them and argue the doubts away. Loudly I'll sing about flowers and spring. Flatly I'll stand on my little flat feet and say, love is a grand and a beautiful thing. I'm in love, I'm in love, I'm in love.
Now, before you give us your answer, there are three things I want to impress you with. First, you're a civilian and you don't have to go. There is no way of our making you go. Second, this is a very dangerous mission, and there's no guarantee that you'll survive or that it'll do any good. Third, it might do a great good. It might be the means of turning the tide of war in this area.
I understand all of these things.
Are you ready to give us your answer?
I am. My answer must be no.
What?
When a man faces death, he must weigh values very carefully. He must weigh the sweetness of his life against the thing he is asked to die for. The probability of death is very great for both of us. I know that island very well, Lieutenant. I am not sure I believe what you are asking
me to
do.
We're asking you to help us lick the Japanese. It's as simple as that. We're against the enemy.
I know what you are against, but what are you for? When I was 22, I thought the world hated bullies as much as I. I was foolish. I killed one, and I was forced to flee to an island. But since then, I have asked help of no one and no country. I have seen these bullies grow strong and multiply, and the world sat by and watched.
Ah, to hell with this, DeBeck. Let's be honest. Aren't you just in love with Nellie, and you're putting her above everything else in the world?
Yes. Yes, I do care about my life with her more than anything else. It is the most important thing to me. This I believe in, this I have, this I am sure of. I cannot risk to lose it. Good day, gentlemen.
Well, he's an honest man. He's wrong. Of course, we can't promise him a better world if we win. Point is, we can be damn sure it'll be worse if we lose, can't we? Well, can't we?
Of course. Gentlemen, there's a bottle of scotch in my bottom drawer. See you tomorrow.
Well, what should I do, Commander Harbison? Report back to my outfit tonight?
Yeah, take a couple of days off. Unwind.
Unwind?
Yeah, sure. Take a boat. Go fishing.
Boat. Now look, Billis, I didn't come over here to Bally High to see anybody cut any boar's teeth out.
Well, it ain't the cutting of the boar's teeth exactly. It's what comes afterwards.
I take you with me. Come, Lieutenant, you have a good time. Marcel, come here. Billis,
Marcel take you to boar ceremony.
Lieutenant come later. Lieutenant come with me. You have good time.
What's this?
You wait.
There's nobody around here.
You wait, Lieutenant.
Ah, Mary, what's going on?
You like?
Who is she?
Liat.
Liat.
Is French name.
Liat.
But no French girl. Is Tonkinese like me. We are very pretty people, people know?
Do you speak English?
Only a few words. She talk French. Français?
Je parle français un peu.
Moi aussi, un peu. Mary? Are you afraid of me? Avez-vous peur?
No. Oui. No.
Thank you. I don't get it. How does Bloody Mary get a kid like you to come here and... I don't get it. Cette ville femme, votre amie.
Ma mère.
Your mother? Bloody Mary is your mother. She didn't tell me.
No, no.
Well, it's the boat, all right. I'll let him wait.
I touch your hand and my arms grow strong, like a pair of birds that burst with song. My eyes look down at your lovely face, and I hold the world in my embrace. Younger than springtime, softer than starlight are you, warmer than winds of June are the gentle lips you gave me, gayer than laughter are you, sweeter than music are you, angel and and when your youth and joy invade my arms and fill my heart as now they do, then younger than springtime am I, gayer than laughter am I. And when your youth and joy invade my arms and fill my heart as now they do, then younger than springtime am I, gayer than laughter am I. Angel and lover, heaven and earth, am I with
again. Ring him again! Hey, I'll take another one of those. Oh, no, not that.
He come, he'll be here soon, Billis, don't worry.
Mary, please tell that boy's too ceremonial fella not to be sore at me. If someone had told me those girls was doing a religious dance, I wouldn't have gotten up and started dancing with them. Hey, here he comes. Wait. Come on. Wait up!
Come back soon, Lieutenant! Bally high! Come back soon!
champagne.
Oh, no, Emile, you know. Oh. I can't stay. I have to get that Jeep back. I stole it. Or rather, I borrowed it. Or rather, a fella stole it for me. A wonderful man named Billis. I have to sneak around behind the hospital as it is.
Well, in that case, I forbid you to go. If you just have to sneak around without anyone noticing you, you might as well sneak back later.
You're absolutely right. Oh, I never had such a wonderful time in my whole life. Oh, those lovely people. Oh, and that cute little old French man who spoke to me in French and made believe he understood me. Oh, and that exciting native couple who danced for us. Oh, oh, it's so different from Little Rock. Oh, no, why are you laughing? Am I drunk?
Oh, no.
Yes, I am. It isn't the champagne. It's you. Mm?
More champagne?
Yes. This is how I feel, living on a hillside. Here we are, like two old married people. Our guests have gone home and we're alone.
This is what I need. This is what I've longed for. Someone young and smiling here upon my hill.
You know, my mother says we have nothing in common. But she's wrong. We have something very important in common. Very much in common.
Yes, we are both in love.
And more than that, we are the same kind of people, fundamentally. You and me, we appreciate things.
We
get enthusiastic about things. It's really quite exciting when two people are like that. We're not blasé.
Blasé?
You know what I mean?
Yes. Nellie, I have a surprise for you. Now, close your eyes. No peeking. No peeking. Bonsoir.
Bonsoir. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness, you are the cutest things I have ever seen in my whole life. What are your names? I bet you don't understand a word I'm saying. Oh, my goodness, you're cute.
Nellie, I want you to meet Ngana and Jerome. Ngana, Jerome, this is Nellie.
Nellie?
Antonioli, Vit.
Venez petit.
Bonsoir, Nellie. Bonsoir, Nellie.
Bonsoir. Oh, my goodness, they're adorable. Those big black eyes staring at you out of those sweet little faces. Are they Henry's?
They are mine.
Yes. Oh, yes. Of course they're yours. They look exactly like you. Now, where did you hide their mother?
Nellie, she is dead.
They are yours.
Yes. I am their father, Nellie.
And their mother, what?
She was a Polynesian. Very beautiful and charming, too.
But you and she...
Ah, I want you to know something. Nellie, I make no apologies. I came here as a young man. I lived as I could.
Of course.
But I was not selfish. No woman ever hated me or tried to hurt me.
Well, no woman would ever want to hurt you. Emile, what time is it? I have to get the Jeep back. Oh, my goodness. No, look at the time.
Nellie, don't go now. I'll take you back later.
No, you will do no such thing anyway. I can't leave the Jeep here. I have to get it back.
Nellie, don't go now. Don't go yet.
This is
please.
Awful. I won't be able to face the girls in the hospital. You have no idea how they look at you when you come in late. I'll call you, Emile. I'll come by tomorrow. Thank you for tonight, Emile. I had a wonderful time. It was the nicest party, and you're the perfect host. Now, please stay here, Emile. Don't come out to the Jeep.
Nellie! I love you. Do you hear me? I love you.
And I love you, too. Honestly, I do. Let me go. Let me go.
Nellie! once you have found her, never let her go. Once you have found her, never let her go. Can you tell me where I can find Miss Forbush?
She's on stage now. She's the MC. She can't talk to nobody right now. You want me to bring her those flowers?
No, I prefer to give them to her myself.
Ah, you're Mr. DeBeck, aren't you?
Yes.
Look, Mr. DeBeck, do me a favor, will you? Don't try and see her tonight.
Why?
Because we got her in a great mood, and I don't want anything to upset her.
She has been upset.
Upset? She asked for a transfer to another island. Day before yesterday, she busted out crying right in the middle of rehearsal, said she couldn't go on with the show. But Captain Brackett talked to her and told her how important it was to the base. So do us all a favor and don't try and see her tonight.
She has asked for a transfer.
Well, don't tell her I told you. Nobody's supposed to know.
I must see her tonight.
Then stay out of sight till after the show. Here, I'll take her the flowers. Don't worry.
Hey, Billis! Billis!
Lieutenant Cable!
Shh! Lieutenant Cable is supposed to be in his little bed over at the hospital.
You have not been well?
I'm okay now. Fever's gone. Ah, they can't hold me in that damn place any longer. I'm looking for a guy named Billis. He's a great guy for getting boats, and I need a boat right now. I've got to get over to my island.
What?
That damned island over there with the two volcanoes on it. Have you ever been over there?
Why, yes.
I went over there every day till this damn malaria stopped me. Have you ever sailed over early in the morning with the warm rain playing across your face? Beginning to see her again like last night.
Mama, c'est lui.
Liot!
I thought I was dreaming.
No.
What are you doing over here?
She come in big white boat. Bigger than your boat. Belong Jacques Barrère. He want to marry Liat. You know him. Is white man too, and very rich.
Is that the old planter you told me about? The one who drinks? My God, you can't let her marry a man like that.
Okay, then you marry her.
Tais-toi. Il est malin tout comprendre. Lieutenant, I am worried about you. You are not well. Will you allow me to take you back to the hospital?
You're worried about me? That's funny. The fellow who says he lives on an island all by himself doesn't worry about anybody. Not the Japanese, not the Americans, not the Germans, not anybody. Why pick out me to worry about?
Forgive me, Lieutenant. I am sorry.
Lieutenant, you like Liat? Marry Liat. You have good life here. Look, Lieutenant, I am rich. I saved $600 before war. Since war, I make $2,000. War go on, I make maybe more. Sell cross skirts, boar's teeth, real human heads. Give all the money to you and Liat. You know how to work. I work for you all day long. You and Liat be together. Walk through woods, swim in sea, sing, dance, talk happy. No, think about Philadelphia is no good. Talk about beautiful things and make love all day long. You like, you buy. Happy talking, talking, happy talk. Talk about things you like to do. You got to have a dream. If you don't have a dream, how you gonna have a dream come true? Talk about the moon floating in the sky, looking like a lily on a lake. Talk about a bird learning how to fly, making all the music he can make. Happy talk, keep talking, happy talk. Talk about things you like to do. Branches of a tree. Talk about a girl, talk about a boy, counting all the ripples on the sea. Happy talk, keep talking, happy talk. Talk about things you like to do. You've got to have a dream. If you don't have a dream,
thank you.
Liat, I want you to have this. It's a man's watch, I know, but it's a good one. It belonged to my grandfather. Oh, it's kind of a lucky piece, too. My dad carried it all through the last war. It's beautiful, isn't it?
When I see you first time, I know you good man for Liat. And she good girl for you. You make special good babies.
Mary. Mary. I can't marry Liat.
Was your last chance! Mary, now she marries Jacques Barret!
Mary, come, listen Liat. To me! Liat.
Give me what? Give me what?
Mary, no. Please!
Up to now, our side has been getting the hell beat out of it in two hemispheres, and we're not going to get to go home until the situation is reversed. It may take a while before we get any really big operation underway, so it's things like this show tonight, that keep us going. Now, I understand that I am not generally considered a sentimental type.
Boy, you can say that again!
Sure. Once or twice, I understand I've even been referred to as old iron belly.
Once or twice?
Just about a million times!
I want you to know that I resent that very much, because I had already chosen that as my private name for our executive officer, Commander Harbison. Take a bow, Commander. I want you to know that both old Iron Belly sat here tonight and had a hell of a good time. And we want to thank that hard-working committee of nurses and Seabees who made up these costumes out of palmetto, parachutes, and pods. And thought up these jokes and these grand songs. And I just want to say on this Thanksgiving Day to all of them from all of us, thank you. And now I want to ask Commander Harbison to introduce the next act, which is the finale of our Thanksgiving entertainment.
The next and last will be a song sung by Bosun Butch Forbush. And that siren of the coral seas, gorgeous, voluptuous, and petite, Mademoiselle Lutheria Billis?
Come on, Bill.
My doll is as dainty as a sparrow. The figure is something to applaud. Yeah! Where she's narrow as an arrow. And she's broad, where a broad should be broad. Dynamite. Her hair is blonde and curly. hips, I call her hips, twirly and whirly. She's my baby, I'm her pap, I'm her booby, she's my trap. I am caught and don't wanna run, cause I'm having so much fun with Honey Bun.
Miss Forbush, I'd like you to know that I think you're the most wonderful world in the entire woman. Now, even including the fact that you're an officer and all. And, well, I just can't go on being such a heel as to let you think I thought of giving you those flowers.
Oh, but you did give them to me, and I appreciate...
No, here's the card that came with them.
Oh.
You all right, Miss Forbush? Look, you know, I'll be waiting around here in the area here just in case you need me. You just sing out, all right?
What's the matter, Nellie the nurse? You having diplomatic difficulties with France?
Joe Cable, who let you out of the hospital?
Me, I'm okay.
You're trying to get over to Valley High. That little girl you told me about.
Liat. I've just seen her for the last time, I guess. I love her. And yet I just heard myself saying I can't marry her. What's the matter with me, Nellie? What kind of guy am I anyway?
Oh, Joe, you're all right. You're just far from home. We're both so far from home.
Nellie, I must see you.
Emile, I can't...
Will you excuse us, Lieutenant?
No, Joe, wait here, please. I have been meaning to call you.
Nellie, you have asked for the transfer. Why? What does
it
mean?
I'll explain it to you tomorrow.
Oh, now, Nellie, what does it mean?
I can't marry you. Do you understand? I can't marry you.
Nellie, is it because of my children?
No, not because of your children. They're sweet.
Then it is their Polynesian mother. Their mother and I.
Yes. I can't help it. It isn't as if I could give you a good reason. I mean, there is no reason. This is emotional. This is something that's born in me.
It is not. I do not believe this is born in you.
Well, then why do I feel the way I do?
Nellie.
All I know is that I can't help it. I can't help it. Joe, explain how
Nellie.
We feel. Danny, are you ready?
Yes. What makes her talk like that? Why do you have these feelings, you and she? I do not believe it is born in you. I do not believe it.
It's not born in you. It happens after you're born. You've got to be taught to hate and fear. You've got to be taught from year to year. It's got to be drummed in your dear little ear. You've got to be carefully taught. You've got to be taught to be afraid of people whose eyes are oddly made and people whose skin is a different shade. You've got to be carefully taught.
That is wrong.
You've got to be taught before it's too late. Before you are 6 or 7 or 8, to hate all the people your relatives hate, you've got to be carefully taught. You've got to be carefully taught.
That is exactly the kind of ugliness I was running away from. It has followed me all of this way, all of these years, and now at last it has found me. I was cheated before, and I'm cheated again by a mean little world of mean little men. And the one chance for me is the life I know best, to be here on an island and to hell with the rest. I will cling to this island like a tree or a stone. I will cling to this island and be free and alone.
This thing alive. I'm not going back there. I'm coming here. For everything I care about is right here.
If all you care about is here, this is a good place to be. If all you care about is taken away from you, there is no place. I was so close to it. So close. One dream in my heart. One love to be living for. One love to be living for. This nearly was mine. One girl clear and deep are my fancies of things I wish were true. I keep remembering evenings I wish I'd spent with you. I keep remembering kisses from lips I'll never own, and all the lovely adventures that we have never known. Now I'm alone, still
Beck, would you reconsider going up there with me to Marie Louise Island? I mean, now that you haven't got so much to lose. We could do a good job, I think, you and I. When I go up there, what side of the island should I land on?
The south side.
Why?
There's a cove. And some rocks. I have sailed in between these rocks many times.
Could a submarine get in between those rocks without being observed?
Yes, if they know the channel.
And after I've landed, what should I do?
You will get in touch with two friends of mine, Basil and Inato, two black men. They will hide us in the hills.
Us? Are you going with me?
Of course. You are too young to be out alone. Come, we must find Captain Brackett.
Oh, wait till old Iron Belly hears this. He'll jump right out of his skin.
I would like to see this kind of a jump. Come.
What's that? What was that?
That was nothing, sir.
We ought to be getting a message now. They'd have had time to land and establish some sort of an observation post by now.
Captain Brackett?
Don't interrupt me now, Bill. I'm very busy.
It's about this Seabee out here, sir. Billis? Yeah, Commander Perkins over at Operations estimates that Billis's little stunt this morning cost the Navy over $600,000.
$600? Well, I'm gonna chew that guy's. Get him in here!
Yes, sir.
Let me know the moment you get any word. No matter what I'm doing, you just break right in.
Yes, sir.
Get in there. Captain? Lieutenant Buzz Adams, who flew the mission?
Hi, Adams.
Captain?
One man like you in an outfit is like a rotten apple in a barrel. Just what did you feel like sitting down there all day long in your little rubber boat in the middle of Empress Augusta Bay with the whole damn Navy Air Force trying to rescue you? And how the hell do you fall out of a PBY anyway?
Well, sir, the enemy anti-aircraft busted a hole in the side of the plane and I fell through. The wind just sucked me out.
So I'm to understand that you deliberately hid in the baggage compartment of a plane that you knew was taking off on a very dangerous mission. You had sand enough for that, all right. And then the moment an anti-aircraft gun hit the plane, you fell out. The wind just sucked you out, you and your little parachute. I don't think you fell out, Billis. I think you jumped out. Which did you do?
Well, sir, it was sort of half and half, if you get the picture.
This is one of the most embarrassing things that ever happened to me. Adams, When did you discover he was on the plane?
Oh, well, sir, we've been out about an hour. It was still dark, I know. We were flying across Marie Louise. The enemy anti-aircraft carrier spotted us, made the hit. That's when Luther, this fella here, that's when he left the ship. I just circled once, you know, time enough to drop him a rubber boat. Some New Zealanders in P-40 spotted him, though, kept circling around him. Well, I flew back across the island, landed alongside the sub, let Joan, the Frenchman, off. By the time I got back to the other side of the island, our Navy planes were flying around in the air above this guy like a thick swarm of bees. Well, they kept the guns occupied while I slipped down and scooped him up off the rubber boat. You'd have thought this guy was a $90 million cruiser they're out to protect. There must have been 55, 60 planes.
62.
You're not far off, Adams. Harbison estimates this thing cost the Navy about $600,000.
$600,000?
What the hell are you so happy about?
Well, sir, I was just thinking about my uncle. Remember my uncle I was telling you about?
Yeah.
Used to tell my old man I'd never be worth a dime. Can you imagine a guy, him and his lousy slot machines?
Why the hell did you do this anyway, Billis? What would make a man do a thing like this?
Well, sir, a fella's got to keep moving. You know, you get kind of held down. So if you're itching to take a trip to pick up a few souvenirs, you got to kind of horn in if you get the picture.
How did you know about it anyway?
Well, now, I didn't really know about it exactly. It's just that I heard Lieutenant Cable talking to that fella to Beck. Right away, I know something's in the air. A project. That's what I like, Captain. Projects, don't you?
Billis, you've broken every regulation in the book. And by God, Captain Brackett and I are gonna throw it at you!
Sir, may I barge in? My co-pilot saw the whole thing, you know? And he thinks that this fella Billis, down there in the rubber boat with all those planes over him, caused kind of a diversionary action. While they were busy shooting at the planes and at Billis, on the other side of that island, that sub was slipping into that cove and depositing Joe Cable and the Frenchman off behind those rocks.
What the hell do you want me to do? Give this man a bronze star?
Well, now, Captain, I don't want a bronze star or anything, but I could use a little freedom. You know, a little room to swing around in, if you know what I mean, if you get the picture.
Get out.
Yes, sir.
Get out of here!
Yes, sir. How about
you? Get the hell out of here! Well, Iron Belly, what would you have done?
I'd have thrown him in the brig. And I will, too, if I get the ghost of a chance.
Captain, I've got them.
And so here we are. This is our first chance to send news to you. We have made contact with former friends of mine, and we have set up our quarters in a mango tree. Not much room, but it is a lovely view, huh? So first, the weather. There are rain clouds over Bougainville, the Treasuries, Choiseul, and New Georgia. We expect rain in this region between 9 o'clock and 2 o'clock.
0900 to 1400.
Pardon. My friend Joe corrects me. We expect rain between 0900 and 1400. And now, our military expert, Joe.
All you Navy, Marine, and Army pilots, write this down. Surface craft, 19 troop barges headed down the bottleneck. Speed about 11 knots, escorted by heavy warships. There ought to be some way to knock off a few of these.
Oh, boy. Where are you going? I don't want to miss that takeoff. We're going to be going out in waves tonight. Waves!
Here, Bill.
Thanks.
You know what I like, Bill? Projects, don't you?
Sailing today, unlimited. 33 fighters. Zero that moved in over Bougainville. Their course is approximately 23 degrees. Undoubtedly, heavy bombers will follow.
Sir, you have to tell her something sometime. She hasn't seen him for 2 weeks. She might as well know now.
Okay, send her in. Send her in. I always have to do the tough jobs.
Captain Brackett, I know this isn't regular. It's about Emile Debeck. I went to his house a few weeks ago to... Well, you know how sometimes people have arguments and then days later you think of a good answer? Well, I went to his house and he wasn't there. I even asked his children and... He has two children and they didn't seem to know where he'd gone. At least I think that's what they said. They only speak French. And then tonight when I was on duty in the ward, we have a lot of fighter pilots over there, you know, the boys that knocked out the convoy yesterday. You know how fighter pilots talk about Immelmanns and wing overs and things? I never listen, usually, but they kept talking about this Frenchman. This Frenchman said that, the Frenchman said this, and I was wondering if the Frenchman that they were talking about could be my Frenchman.
Yes, Miss Forbush, it is. I couldn't tell you before, but As a matter of fact, if you wait here a few minutes, you can hear his voice.
His voice? Where is he?
With Lieutenant Cable behind enemy lines.
Behind?
Sir, it's Tibet.
The Japanese are pulling out. I repeat, the Japanese are pulling out. There is great confusion. Our guess is that they will try to evacuate their troops from Cape Esperance tonight. You may not hear from us for several days. We must move again. There are two planes overhead. We think they are looking for us. We believe that it's...
Oh, my God! Oh, my God!
Go! Lieutenant Cable, my dear friend, Joe, is dead. I have never known a finer man.
Is that all? Is that all? Can't you get them back?
No, sir. They're cut off.
Poor Joe. Poor Joe Cable. Captain Brackett, do you think there's a chance I'll ever see Emile again?
There's a chance. Of course there's a chance.
I didn't know he was going.
Of course not. How could he tell you he was going? Now, don't blame Emile Debeck.
He has got a chance, hasn't he, Bill?
Oh, sure. There's always a chance.
Come back so I could tell you something. I know what counts now. You, all those other things, the woman you had before, her color, what piffle, what a knucklehead I was. Oh, come back so I could tell you. Oh my God, don't die until I could tell you. All that matters is you and I being together. Don't die, Emile.
Mother of Liat.
Who?
Liat. She won't marry no one but Lieutenant Cable.
Oh, my darling.
A mile down the beach. Suppose they call our names.
Yeah, they may be ready for us to go aboard.
They won't be ready for us for hours yet. This is the Navy. Eager beavers, look at that beach. Crawling with 10,000 guys. All jerks. Oh, hi, Miss McGregor. You nurses going too?
Only a few of us. We're gonna fly back some wounded.
Is Miss Forbush going with you?
I don't know. She might be staying here at the hospital.
Miss McGregor, you don't get airsick, do you? Because I was thinking, if you got $3 handy, you might be able to use this little package I got here.
Oh, that stuff's no good. We gave that up last month.
That is a female jerk. Sir, can I speak to you a moment, sir?
Who's that?
Billis, sir. Luther Billis.
What do you want, Billis? We're moving out soon.
Yes, sir, I know. I wanted to do something for Miss Forbush, sir. So, Stewpot, the professor, and me was wondering if anything was being done about rescuing that Frenchman off that island. Well, we hereby volunteer for such a mission, sir. A triple diversionary activity, like I done to get him on there. See, you drop us in 3 rubber boats on 3 separate sides of the island. Confuse the hell out of the enemy. You get the picture?
It's very good of you, Billis, but you're too late for diversionary activity. That started this morning before the sun came up. Operation Alligator got underway. Landings were made on 14 Japanese-held islands.
I think that's very unfair, sir. The first thing that they should have done was try to rescue that French guy off the island.
Now, the Admiral agrees with you, Billis. Marie-Louise was the first island they hit.
What, did they get him? Is he alive?
We don't know. Lieutenant Buzz Adams flew up there to find out. He's not back yet. But if the Frenchman's dead, it is unfair. It'd be too damn bad if a part of this huge operation couldn't have saved one of the two men that made it all possible.
God, look at the beach. Far as the eye can see, men waiting to board ships. The whole picture of the South Pacific has changed. We're going the other way!
Captain Brackett, sir, the launch is ready to take you to your ship.
You got a ship, sir?
Yes. Harbison and I finally got a ship. I'm no longer a lousy island commander. Come on, Bill.
Well, bye-bye, Commander Harbison.
Goodbye, Billis. Oh, by the way, never did get you in the brig, did I?
No.
Yeah, I forgot.
Hey, I forgot what, sir?
Your unit will be on our ship. I'll be seeing all of you. Get the picture?
Ah, shut up.
Now, the big ones are battleships, and the small ones are destroyers. Or cruisers. Oh, I never can tell the difference. Ah, what on earth are those?
P-40s.
That's right. They're all moving out now, because there's been a big change. Won't be around here much anymore, just a few of them now and then. Do you understand anything I'm saying? Vous ne comprenez pas?
Oui, oui. Nous comprenons.
Oui. Good. Now, while I'm at the hospital, you have to promise me to manger everything that's put before you on the table. Sur le tobler. Sur le tobler?
Sur le top.
Now come over here, Jerome. Sit down. Asseyez-vous. Now, you have to learn to mind me when I talk to you. You have to be nice to me, because I love you very much. Now, manger.
Chante, Nellie.
Oh, no! I will not sing that song. You just want to laugh at my French accent. All right. You have to help me.
La vie est gaie. Dites-moi pourquoi, chère mademoiselle. Est-ce que, parce que, je m'aime. Once you have found her, never.
We'll be right back.